Imagine a line slicing through the center of the Earth, dividing it into two hemispheres, northern and southern. This useful tool of the imagination is well known as the equator. Due to the Earth's spherical form and slight inclination on its axis, the regions along the equator continually receive the highest intensity of sunlight throughout the year, while the polar areas receive minimal sunlight, making them incredibly cold all year round. Given that equatorial regions bear the brunt of the sun's rays throughout the year, it would seem reasonable to assume that they are scorchingly hot. The reality, however, deviates from that straightforward assumption. The hottest parts of our Earth are not located along the equator, but in the areas found within the Tropic of Cancer to the north of the equator and in the Tropic of Capricorn, located to its south. When analyzing a world map showing the planet's major deserts, one would find these barren wastelands close to the Tropic of Cancer, like the Sahara, Iranian, Thar, and North American deserts, or the Tropic of Capricorn, where the Namib, Kalahari, Atacama, and Australian deserts are situated. This might seem peculiar since the equatorial regions, not the tropics, absorb the highest amounts of sunlight. So why are the tropics hotter? The explanation revolves around the fact that while the equator receives the most sunlight, a large quota of this solar radiation is absorbed in evaporating seas and other aquatic bodies, which does not contribute to raising the ambient temperature. This results in humid, warm air hovering over equatorial oceans and consequently forming clouds. The high concentration of clouds in equatorial regions is what results in the frequent rainfall experienced in these areas. As this moist and warm air rises and loses much of its moisture, it continues to ascend, attempting to journey towards the poles. However, it is rerouted by the Coriolis effect, which forces it to return towards the Earth's tropical surfaces. While descending into the tropical zones, this now arid air heats up further. This is due to the compression of the dry air at lower altitudes, which causes an increase in its temperature. Typically, a 1 kilometer descent in moist air results in a temperature increase of 6 degrees Celsius. However, if the air is dry, the temperature will rise roughly 10 degrees Celsius. Therefore, an initial temperature of 30 degrees Celsius at the equator can culminate in a final temperature of 42 degrees Celsius within the tropics once all the thermal dynamics are accounted for. This effectively explains why the ambient temperature in the tropics is higher than that along the equator, and why many of the world's major deserts are found within the vicinity of the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn, rather than along the equator. Enhanced sunshine throughout the year also plays a contributing role here. This phenomenon can be attributed to the descent of air from the boundary between the troposphere and stratosphere in regions like Western Australia, North Africa, the Middle East, and southwestern United States, all of which are located on the eastern fringe of subtropical high-pressure systems.